What's good with it and the who with it? You already know what it is. Today, Gunner's Profiles. Bang, bang. And in that fashion, and trip out in a minute, style in a direct fashion, we're going to get straight into it. And as you can tell by that thumbnail right there, yes, indeedy, graffiti on the bus with no added preservatives. Now, the story I wanted to tell about is funny, man. I got to chopping it up with the homie earlier, and we were conversating, man, having a good old time. And all of a sudden, he reminded me of a story that I thought was hilarious, but at the same time, rather tragic. And I'm going to tell this story because it's a real one. You know, it's a factual one. And I think that you guys are going to enjoy. So sit back, relax, let the rhymes tax, and maintain MCs with the doubly mac. Strap on your seatbelt, I said. Guard! We're going to get into it, right? So I told you I've been to Jamestown twice. The first time I got to Jamestown, for those of you that don't know, it was a rather unbecoming yarda, meaning that it wasn't a yard that Norteños could function on at that particular point in time. It was a bad yard. It was a yard that if you got to, you had a certain amount of time to get gone, right? And I definitely was going to take the initiative as an active Norteño to be out of there. You're out of here, right? Someone was going to go with me, though. Believe me, I wasn't going to go alone. I wasn't going to get there. I can't be here because that's the way that my Norteñoism works, right? No, there was no none of that. I paid that, no, never mind. What I did is definitely got right in the mix and got off right in R&R on a vato that was wanted in the highest degree. Now, I've told that story before, and I'm not going to reiterate it, but what I am going to say is this. On the second go around, yes, I did get to Jamestown, and this time, I was no longer in the best of standings. This time, I was pushed back. This time, I was not an active North anyway, right? So I could pretty much go wherever they place me and do whatever I want. Now, I get to the yarda, and there's some characters there. There's some characters that have even been on YouTube that you might just know, but I'm not going to speak on their name because they're no longer with us. There are some characters that were unbecoming of any type of yard California has ever seen. Now, at the same time, what you do when you get to these 50-50 type yards is you kick it with amongst the few homeboys that you meet that are righteous, that you believe are righteous, that have good paperwork, and you guys just function and do your own thing. A few burpees never hurt nobody, a little SOS in the morning, Sasuke Grand Slam on Sundays, and the winner was, right? I was just trying to do what last little bit of time I had pocket change time. I was trying to do that and get right back to regular schedule program on the calles. So I paid the yarda, no, never mind. But of course, when you're on a prison yard, you have to be aware. It doesn't matter what type of yard you're on. It doesn't matter. You know, there's always individuals that might be waking up having a bad day, and they're going to make your... See that one right there? And he's having a bad day, and he's going to continue to have a bad day. Now you're going to have a bad day because he's having a bad day. Bang, bang. That's just how it is. So you definitely got to stay aware. And some of these places, it's a lot more tragic and stressful than anywhere else, because at least in the general population yard, you know, people ain't going to just make the next move, their best move, because there's certain people that they have to ask to do that. On these type of yards, people are going to do what they does, because now half the yard that was functioning, the other half was boo-boo, I guess, of whatever you want to call it, right? I was on the boo-boo side. I was on the side of the yarda where we didn't have to answer to nobody but ourselves. And as grown men, ain't that the way it's supposed to be? Well, it was at that point in time, right? But guaranteed that I was an al-boo-boo, right? I was definitely willing to get off where I was mad at. But at the same time, hey, I'm just trying to go home and sit, right? But I wasn't never going to function with no weirdos or anything like that. So look at it. Trip out on this story. So I met a couple good righteous homeboys. And one of the homeboys that I met, I'm not going to even tell you what area he was out of, because I don't want to upset his peoples. But at the same time, he became a good friend. Came a good homeboy, workout partner, dude was a beast, tall homeboy, all on swole. You know, he was one of those type of homeboys that if you met him and you seen him, you were like, all right, now they're about to go places. They're about to got charisma, they're about to go on swole, they're about to got hands, right? I seen him beat up a couple people. I knew, you know, that he was a righteous dude. You know, he wasn't in there on no bad charges, no bad cases, nothing like that. Like I said, the vato was, I wasn't sleeping with the vato, but one thing I do know for sure is he was a good camarada, a good friend, and we continued to do that for about a year. Now, trip out. They placed us in the kitchen. Actually, he went to go work in the kitchen first. So I was like, get me pulled in there. I'm starving, eh? I'm trying to eat. And everybody wants a hustle while they're locked up. And the kitchen is a great, it's an immaculate hustle. Guard, you know that, right? It's a hustle because you can make sandwiches, bring them out, sell them 2 for $5. I mean, the hustle was just so real. Plus, you eat good. And as long as you're staying healthy and eating healthy, you can work out. You got the stamina to go the rounds if you need to. So the homeboy definitely took a little while, but he was able to get me pulled into the kitchen with them. And I appreciate that, right? Now I'm in the kitchen, and I started to elevate my status within the kitchen. Meaning, I went from the dishwasher to the table wiper to orale. Now I'm in the back where it really cracks, right? Orale, I'm stealing sausages and bacon and everything online. I'm making bomb breakfast sandwiches. My people's dependent on me. I had clientele. I was like a doctor to my patients. Orale, they knew every Sunday, pura, I had the pancakes and the peanut butter. Watcha, right? Look at the gun doing his thing. So the wiggle was real. Plus, I was extorting a couple people, and yeah, I ain't gonna lie, about the sugar products, you know? And I was getting some sugar, some jelly, things of that nature. The pruno game was real. That's prison. That's prison living, man. Everyone's hustling. Everyone's wiggling. Everyone's moving constantly. There's a lot going on behind the scenes. Pay no attention to the man that's behind the curtain because he's definitely trying to get all the sugar in the cocina. So now, look, trip out. I'd been there for a while, and everything's good. And what happens is this homeboy that I thought was my righteous homeboy, that was my taita, you know, he's like the main cook there now. He's got the keys for everything. Ese devato could go wherever he needs to go at any particular time. And you don't really pay him no mind. He's the homeboy, man. If he's over here on the other side of the kitchen doing his thing, I'm not going to be over there like a perro, like all on him. Hey, what are you doing, homie? Nah, he's doing his thing. I'm doing mine. He knows I'm hustling. He's hustling. Well, a chiruhu gets to the yard. For those of you that don't know what a chiruhu is, there's a lot of other channels. And just watch them. And you'll know, right? There's a chiruhu that comes on the yard. Now, this chiruhu was different. Different than many other ones that have ever gotten to that yard that got found out. Like, Sasuke, I thought a big old beard. Now look at him, right? He's over there with a two-fist and a chorra. It wasn't that type of one. It was one that actually looked like a hyena. Couldn't tell the difference. You know what I mean? Maybe after 3 days, a little stubble popped out. But other than that, you just didn't know. Now, me, myself, in particular, I've never had some hatred or animosity towards anyone that doesn't rock the way I rock. Hey, that's on them, man. You know, if they like chorra, there's a chorra sandwich on every block. Believe me, three pot, they'll give it to you. Right? So I just... It just was never my mix. I didn't pay it. No, never mind. But one thing I do know for sure is everybody on that yard, and I said a lot of everybody, right? We're on this vato's jock, like if his name was Melanie or something. I don't know. I can't call it like an alcoholic, but I know this vato was the talk of the town. He gets there, and vatos that you didn't even think swang that way were definitely swanging, right? Vatos are on the handball court trying to pull it. Hey, what's happening? You know what I mean? What's happening? They were doing their thing. And from a distance, I'm like, look at these babosos. Now, my homeboy was saying the same thing I was, but even a little bit more aggressive. He was like, man, I can't believe these disgusting individuals do something like this. I say, it's prison, homes. Let the vatos do what they do, but this is going to expose the good men from the... You know what I mean? Oh, hell nah, right? And then we know not to go around them. You know, in particular, that vato right there. Watch out. Look, where's his hand? Pensa la tira. You know what I mean? So we knew what time it was. So eventually, over time, about a month later, this chiruhu gets moved into the kitchen. Now, the officer that was working in the kitchen, we had a set cop, okay? You had free staff that would, like, watch everything that you'd done. They wore the brown uniforms. They would make sure that, you know, certain things were placed where they needed to be placed. And they were free staff from the streets, meaning they'd come in, and their particular job was just to make the food thing happen. And after that, they were gone, right? Oh, hell no. Out of here. But the black guy that worked in there, he was an older viejito. I remember he took a distaste or a dislike to this individual when he was placed in the kitchen. He was like, oh, hell no. Sit your in. Made a couple phone calls and realized that there was nothing he could do about it. That vato was going to be there one way or another. Right now, this vato, the cop, the placa, decided that if for no other reason, he didn't want this individual around the comida. I ain't going to lie. After seeing what his hands did out there on the yarda, I didn't either. Right? Bam. So this vato was placed on mop duty and cleaning the table duty. Right? Now, trip out. This place, it had like two sides of the kitchen. So you'd walk in one side or two sides of the dining rooms. You'd walk in one dining room. There was another dining room with a big wall in between on the other side. So when after everybody would leave, immediately we'd start cleaning the dishes, clean the tables. You had all kinds of pans, pots, and all kinds of things in the back. And of course, that's when we try to hustle. As soon as everyone left, we're over there trying to make sandwiches as quick as possible and do our job at the same time. Hey, that's the hustle in prison. Everyone knows what it is that worked in the kitchen before, right? You get the double up trays. Everyone's eating the double it. It's called the double it. We're getting ours on. Guard! You didn't always get the double up, huh? Yes, we were, sir. Bang, bang. So anyways, eat the double up. Take whatever you don't want off the extra trays, man. Start making sandwiches so you can take back and get your hustle on. Because everybody's waiting on you on the block. They're like, oh, we had sausage today. I know my boy, the gun gun's going to come through like that. For surely, though. There was this one brother who used to wait on me like, get me, man. Get me. Get me. I got you, right? Now, trip out. So when this chiruhu started working in there, at first there was no problems. I paid him no never mind. I'd walk by him like, damn, I was like, how do you smell like Fantasy by Mariah Carey, right? Man, it's crazy. How did that work? But I'd walk by and just pay him no never mind. It wasn't none of my business. I wasn't one of those type of individuals, oh, don't touch me there, right? Because I wasn't getting that close. But I definitely just didn't care about the next man's program. So I'm mobbing, doing my thing, regular scheduled program, and I started to notice that a lot of the guys that I would see, because we'd be in there busting down, working out, joking, all that, they were starting to disappear. Like, what are these vectors doing? Are they rolling it up? Are they piecing it up? To what degree of, how are you going to do that here, right? They started to become MIA until one day, I see there's like a back bathroom that we used to use. You know what I mean? There's a whole gaggle of guys over there, a whole line of guys in the bathroom. And I look, and of course, Melanie is in there, right? I said, oh, hell nah, right? Gah! Anyways, they're doing a thing. I'm disgusted. You know, I almost wanted to, I got Asco. Oh, man, I got to go over here to the other kitchen, right? So I bounce, and I said, that's what DeVop's been up to. Man, I can't talk to no one in here. I feel like I'm alienated. Now, my homeboy seen the same thing. He was like, I can't believe these guys. I can't believe they'd be into that. And I'd be like, bro, it's just me and you till the wheels fall off. Bro, we can't be going down like that. You see what they got going on over there, bro? We're in prison, that's it, right? This is really the pen, right? No, these ain't the streets, homie. That was the pen, and sorry, there was no tortillas, but there was a whole lot of Miklos sucking on fingers in there, or other things. Anyways, so, like I said, this Cheeto who was relegated to cleaning tables and mopping floors, so he would always be on the other kitchen, which the righteous guys try to stay away from. Well, one day I had to go get the mop bucket because someone spilled some eggs, right? So I went over there to go get the mop bucket, you know what I mean? I'm just doing my thing, I'm whistling while I work. And then I went around the corner. And then I seen my homeboy, Big Boy. And then I looked, then I seen the Cheeto. And then I seen I didn't want to, right? I can't even explain what I seen, but let's just say there was a whole lot of kissing involved and all kinds of things of that nature. With my boy, I said, oh, hell no. I did it like in slow motion. No. He looked at me like, bro. The Cheeto took his head out of his lap like, whoa. I was like, oh, no, hell no. I dipped out of there. Needless to say, it was that day that we severed the relationship as far as being friends, me and the homeboy. He didn't say nothing to me. He didn't explain himself. I didn't ask him no questions. It was just like, despicable, right? I'm gone. Despicable me. That was his new nickname, Despicable Me. So anyways, I end up getting moved up out the kitchen. I can't take it. I can't take it. Hey, Woods, no, I couldn't take it, brother, right? I got to get up out of here, man. This is a love fest back here to which I don't want to be involved in. Yes, I'm saying it's actual fest. There was a few other bottles that weren't indulging, right? We're up out of there. At least I know I was. Hey, I don't get down. I got too many tortas to buzz down like that. You know, with the mañana. I'm trying to buzz down with a tortilla, so I'm out. What happened from then on was the homie who I thought was my homie, but now he acts like he don't know me, and I definitely don't want to know him, goes all the way to holding hands on the yarda with this thing, walking around the track. Just despicable. Me, I'm like, damn, look at that. With the other homeboys, were sitting there right there on the tables like, mira te vato, remember? Used to be hard. Now, go pull his card. The other one was, oh, that's a big guy. What right there? I ain't trying to play that game. He just be walking around all me mugging. You know what I mean? The other one thought the 5 o'clock shadow. It was ugly. Anyways, to each their own, that was his business. But he was making it everyone else's business by slapping everyone in the face, basically, by displaying it on the yard. He had a whole bunch of Africana brothers all mad. What is she seeing him? She don't see me. I'm going to tell you what. First of all, that ain't a she. You know what I mean? What are you seeing that? I don't know. All I know is just the Woods were like, brother. And brothers, right? It was crazy. Trip out. They end up getting celled up together. That's how bad it was there. The Placa seen it, knew that someone was doing the Miklo, and still celled them up together. That'd be like Big Al and Popeye celled up together. Give me your chocho. No, Texas barbecue. No, I want the chocho. No, I want the Texas barbecue. They'd be on repeat. And sorry, there wouldn't be no tortillas because the Mexicanos would be like, oh, hell no, right? Anyways, so they end up getting celled up together. Now, here's the funny part of the story. If you ain't been laughing yet, they get celled up, and there comes the day, and I mean, everyone knows, they're in a relationship, that's husband and husband, they're over there doing their thing, right? Everybody knows on the tier, it smells like nothing but caca and baby oil, it's just a bad situation, and I know that one day they go to the home, which was the homie, I'm going to refer to him as the homie, but you know, Despicable Me, we'll just say, they go to Despicable Me cell, and they tell him, hey, you're rolling up, tomorrow you're transpacking, you're leaving, homes, you're shipping out. This vato refused. Him and his, I want to be your lover, whatever it is. Him and his prince, boy, they literally boarded up the cell, put paper on the cell. The blackest had to go in there. They locked this all down. They went and they extracted him, cell extracted him. Like, no, Vato, you're going. Sorry, you got to go to Corco, right? He didn't want to go. And it wasn't because he was scared to go to another prison. This is a big boy, man. He'll mess around and put people on their back. And he was in there literally putting them on his back, right? He'll do that. But more so, he didn't want to leave his friend. His secret friend, right? Or his, not even a secret. He just didn't want to. Secret lovers, yeah. That's what they are. They're Despicable Me. Anyways, he didn't want to leave Hornswoggle over there in the corner. Hey, this about to fight tooth and nail. No, please. I said, hell no. I won't go, right? They put him in the oil. We're hearing from the distance. It's about to be in the back screaming, Esperanza! Devonta did not want to leave anywhere, right? Eventually, they end up shipping him out. And within 2 days, there was a brother up in the cell talking about, I don't know nothing, cuz. You know, on Bob. It was, all I know is this. These are facts. This happened. The homeboy got played out by a punk on the yard. And I remember, I always trip on it because you think it's your good homeboy. You think he's a righteous dude. You think everyone thinks alike. Now, like I said, at the end of the day, man, ain't nothing wrong with whatever anyone else believes. If they want to go that route, it's it. Thinky. Go that route. That's on you, Holmes. I don't encourage it, nor do I endorse it, nor do I say discourage it. Just please. I don't want to see anything. You know, I don't get down, you know. I'm going to just do it in that fashion. But I was highly disappointed because this was a righteous dude that I rocked with that I thought we had the same, you know, kind of thinking. Now, I'm not the type of person that's going to hate on anyone for their, you know, sexual preferences or anything. I don't care, you know. I got friends that got friends that are, that got friends, right? But, and it's cool, you know, to each their own. You know, I'm a man. I know how a man shall rock. But I was disappointed. Ivato thought he was high power too. He said, man, look at them vatos, man. Now that I think back, this is how it really was going in his mind. Man, look at them vatos, man. Damn, I was supposed to be first, eh? Anyways, it was very unnatural and out of the ordinary, but it did happen. That's why I tell you, prison is a different animal. Things happen in there that won't necessarily happen on the calles. Man, I done seen vatos, well-known individuals that everyone knows on YouTube. It's crazy, right? Up on the second tier, I'm on the bottom tier, and the vato's screaming with his boyfriend, please, don't leave me, right? I'm telling you, the game's ugly. With that being said, I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you laughed a little bit, man. It's not meant to discourage or to hurt anyone, their feelings, because I know the vato right now just poked his head out of his lap, his homeboy, like, why is Gunner talking like that? And I'm going to stay, and you see the vato Gunner? I'm going to continue to talk like that, because it's real. With that being said, move smooth with a purpose. Get every single thing that you want coming to you. Remember right here on Gunners Profiles as well as Gunners Collective, we about to get it in, but not like that. We about to get it in a real way, man. 7 days a week, we're going to drop Bangladeshes. It's what we does, cuz, and we don't stop. We're going to say it with a chest like Wes, but we're not going to put nothing up our culo like Wes. You already know what it is. If you like this, hit that like and subscribe with a thumbs up. If not, you can hit me with that thumbs down. Heavy's going to be the head that wears the crown. I'm going to continue to strive and struggle. Guard! I said strive and struggle, puto. Not struggle to strive, right? And I'm going to do what I does because you already know what it is, man. This is the gun where I'm here, set on this earth, first and foremost, forever forward, to bring together the gente so that we can laugh a little, have a good time, and at the end of the day, man, speak on some real stuff. You know what it is, man. I'm about to fail for a despicable me. Esperanza! The gun.